Sri Gurubhyo Namaha children. Today we are going to see perimeter and area exercise 14E. See the first sum. Find the circumference of a circle. Give your answer in terms of pi. Radius is equal to 39 1/2 meter. Okay. So we have radius and mixed fraction, that is 39 1/2 meter. When you convert this in improper, you will get 39 into 2 78 plus 1 79 79 by 2 meter. And you know the formula for circumference of a circle in terms of radius. Circumference of a circle in terms of radius means we will use 2 pi r units. Okay, so 2 into 22 by 7. Sorry, actually pi we have to keep as it is, right? We have to give the answer in terms of pi. So pi, and the radius is 79 by 2. When I cancel 2 and 2, I'll get 79 pi meter. Okay, do you understand? Shall we move to the next one? Use pi is equal to 22 by 7 to find the circumference of a circle. Diameter is equal to 6.3 meter. See, your diameter is given 6.3 meter. So, I am going to find the circumference of a circle. Circumference of a circle is equal to, in terms of diameter, we can use pi d also. Yes? Yes? So, pi we are going to take 22 by 7. It is given in the question. So, 22 by 7 into 6.3. When I cancel, I will get 0.9. When I multiply 22 into 0.9, I will get 19.8 meter. Okay. So, do you understand? Shall we move to the next one? So, use pi is equal to 3.14 meter. To find the circumference of a circle, radius is 2 kilometer. Okay, so I'm going to find the circumference of a circle. In terms of radius means, I can use this formula, 2 pi r units. So, 2 into pi is given as 3.14 and r is 2 kilometer. So, 2 2's are 4. 4 into 3.14, when I multiply, what I will get? 12.56 kilometer. Okay. Shall we move to the next? Find the length of a diameter of a circle whose circumference is 44 kilometer. See here, circumference is given and we are supposed to find the diameter. So, circumference of a circle is given 44 centimeter, and we are going to find the length of the diameter. So, what is the formula for circumference of a circle? Pi d. Pi d is equal to 44. So, 22 by 7 into d is equal to 44. D is equal to 44 into 7 by 22. 22 ones are, 22 twos are. Yes. So, D is equal to 7 to 14 centimeter. So, therefore the diameter of a circle is 14 centimeter. Do you understand this? Shall we move to the next one, children? See the fifth sum. Find the circumference of a circle whose circumference is 314 centimeter. So, we are going to find the circumference of a circle. So, we actually find the radius of a circle. Okay. Find the radius of a circle whose circumference is 314 centimeter. Okay. So, we are supposed to find the radius of a circle. How will you find this radius of a circle when circumference is given? So, we are going to use circumference of a circle 314 centimeter in the formula for circumference of a circle in terms of radius, because we have to find radius. So 2 pi r is equal to 314 centimeter. So 2 into pi is given as 3.14, and r we are going to find 314 centimeter. So r is equal to 314 divided by 2 into 3.14. Okay, so I'm going to multiply with 100 to the numerator and denominator. So when I multiply with 100, what I'll get? 31,400 by 2 into 314.00. There is no value for this 0, so I'll get 314. So when I cancel, what I'll get? 314 ones are, this is 100 sir. So when I cancel with the two table, 2 ones are 250s are 100. So our radius is equal to 50 centimeter. Do you understand? Shall we move to the next one? See the sixth sum, children. The diameter of Ravi's bicycle tire measures 63 centimeter. How far does the bicycle move when the wheel makes one complete revolution? Take pi is equal to 22/7. Okay. Listen. What is given? Diameter is given. Diameter of this bicycle is given 63 centimeter. And one complete revolution means, it means circumference. Okay. So circumference of the wheel. Okay. So circumference of the wheel. Okay, so we have to find the circumference of the wheel in terms of diameter, means we will use pi d units. Okay, they asked us to take pi is equal to 22/7 and d is 63. 7 ones up, 7 nines up. When I multiply, what I'll get? 198 centimeter. So what is our answer? One complete revolution is equal to 198 centimeter. Do you understand? Yes. Shall we move to the seventh one? Yeah. See the seventh question. It took 125.6 meter of fencing to enclose a circular garden. Find the length of the radius of the garden. Take pi is equal to 3.14. Okay. So they said took fencing. For fencing, 125.6 meter means, what is this? This is actually circumference. They have given the circumference as 125.6 meter. Okay, we are going to find the length of the radius of the garden. How will you find the length of the radius of the garden? Circumference in terms of radius means we will use 2 pi r is equal to 125.6. Okay, so 2 into pi is given as 3.14 and r is equal to 125.6. So r is equal to 125.6 by 2 into 3.14. Okay, I'm going to multiply with 100 both the numerator and denominator, because we have two decimal place. So when I multiply, what I'll get? 1, 2, 5, 6, 0, 0. One decimal place when I keep, there is no value for this 0. And this 2 into 314.00. There is no value for this 0. Yes, when I cancel with the 2 table, I'll get 6 1280. Okay, see now when I can directly cancel with 314. See, 1 zar, this is 20 zar. Yes, you can see. So we are getting the radius is 20 meter. Okay, so we are getting the radius is 20 meter. So they asked us to find the length of the radius of the garden. Therefore, the length of the radius of the garden is 20 meter. Okay. Yes, let us see the next one, 8th one. Priyanka walked around the edge of a circular swimming pool, estimated that she had walked 176 meters, then she swam across the pool by following a diameter about how far did she swim. Okay, so take pi is equal to 22/7. Okay, so Priyanka walked around the edge of a circular swimming pool and estimated that she had walked. So what does it mean? They have given the circumference of the circle, right? Circumference of the swimming pool. So circumference of the swimming pool, it is given meter. Okay, so we are supposed to find a diameter. So shall I use the formula pi d in this place? Yes. Can I use pi d units in this place? 176. So in terms of pi, what I have to take? 22/7 to d. So when I bring this side, 7/22. So when I cancel, I'll get 11s are. When I cancel this with 2 table, I'll get 88. So 11 ones are 11, 11 8s are 88. So 7 8s are 56 meter. So how far did she swim? They said, okay, she's following through this diameter and crossing this pool. Okay, so therefore she swam 56 meter. Okay. Do you understand this sum? Shall we move to the next one? The equatorial diameter of the earth is approximately 12,754 kilometer in length. What is approximate circumference of the earth at the equator? They asked us to find the circumference of the earth. They are given the diameter is 12,754 kilometer. Okay, and we are supposed to find the circumference of the earth. Okay, we know the formula and diameter is given. So we are going to use pi d units. So what is pi? 22/7. And d here, what is d? 12,754. Okay, so when I cancel with the 7 table, what I'll get? 22. Yes, correct. 1822. When I multiply this, I'll get 40,084 kilometer. Therefore, what is our answer? Circumference of the earth at the equator is 40,084 kilometer. Okay, do you understand? Shall we move to the next one? Yes, see this. Find the perimeter of each of the following shapes. We are going to find the perimeter of the each shapes. Okay, so here you should notice that we are going to find this boundaries only, right? That is called perimeter. Yes, so how will we find this? How shall we find this? You see, actually D is given, no? So according, this is a semicircle and we are going to take pi d by 2. Semicircle means pi d by 2. So how many pi d we have? So pi d by 2. Okay, so we are going to take pi d by 2, same like this one, pi d by 2. How many pi d by 2 we have? 4 times, right? So perimeter of this shape, perimeter is equal to pi d by 2 plus pi d by 2 plus pi d by 2 plus pi d by 2. Okay, 4 pi d by 2. So when I cancel, that is we are getting 2 pi d. So 2 into 3.14 into, what is the diameter is given? 8. So when I multiply 3.14 into 16, I will get 50.24 centimeter. Okay, now let us see the B sum. Okay, see the B sum, what is given in this place? The radius is given as 16 mm. Okay, and instead of radius, so this is actually a quadrant. Okay, so quadrant means 1/4 of the circle, right? In terms of radius means we have the formula 2 pi r by 4, because 1/4 of the circle. So 2 pi r by 4, this alone. Okay, when I take this alone, I can say 2 pi r by 4, this curve alone. And next, what else we have? We have to find the boundaries of this, right? So what is 1 radius? This is also 1 radius. So I have 2 radius. So plus 2r. Okay. So when I do this, 1s are, 2s are, and I'll get 3.14 into what is r? 16 by 2 plus 2 into 16. Okay. When I cancel, I'll get 25.12 plus 32. When I add this, I'll get 57.12. Okay. Do you understand this? Yes. Same like this, we are going to do this one. Okay. This is actually diameter is given. Yes. Yes, we are going to find this one, right? Or else 2 pi r by 2 we can use, or we can use pi d by 2 you can use. Okay. And diameter is given. So we are going to find this perimeter, this one, and this one, this one, and this one. Okay, the boundary of this shape. So will we find perimeter is equal to, so pi d by 2, this circle curve alone pi d by 2, and then this side we have 15 and this side we have 40. See here, it's like a rectangle. So if this is 15 meter, this is also 15 meter, so plus 50. Okay, so when you apply the values, 3.14 into diameter is 40. Yes, diameter is 40. So 40 by 2 plus, when you add this, 15 plus 40 plus 15, that is 70. When you cancel this, you will get 20. So 20 into 3.14, you will get 62.8 plus 70. So when you add this, you will get 132.8 meter. Okay, do you understand this, children? I hope you all know how to find this. Yes. Okay, thank you, children.